KNIME Analytics Platform has a simple regression tree learner node to train a regression tree. Let's see how we can set up the tree learner node. The simple regression tree learner node takes the training data at the input port and produces the regression tree model at the output port. In the configuration window, we specify the target column, or the outcome variable, as well as the input features. In this example, we use a car dataset and we are interested in predicting the miles per gallon of a car, explained by the numerical feature horsepower. These radio buttons allow us to select the input features manually, one by one, or in bulk, using a wildcard or a regular expression pattern. For nominal features, we can force the split to be binary by finding the optimal threshold. Two options for handling missing values are available: XGBoost, which is a default, as well as surrogate. To control the size of the tree, and therefore to avoid overfitting, we can specify the number of levels or the tree depth. We can also specify the minimum node size or the minimum number of data points in leaf nodes. Alternatively, we can specify the minimum number of data points required for a split. This number has to be at least twice the minimum node size. In this example, we limit the tree depth to 3 and the minimum node size to 10 in order to avoid overfitting. After executing the tree learner node, we can examine the resulting regression tree by right-clicking the output port and selecting View Regression Tree View. Here, you can select a node and expand all of its branches. In addition, you'll be able to see how the input features were split, what threshold, and in what order. In this example, you can see that when the tree is fully expanded, there are 8 different leaf nodes representing 8 distinct target values in the regression model. The model trained in a learner node can be used in a simple regression tree predictor node. As in other machine learning predictor nodes, the input to this node includes the trained model from the learner node, as well as the testing data. Configuration window is simple and only offers the option to rename the prediction column from the default name. The performance of the model can be summarized by various metrics calculated in the numeric scorer node. In this example, our model had R-square of 0.7. In other words, 70% of all variability was explained by this regression tree model. If we visualize the results with the predictions overlaid on the actual data in a scatter plot, we can see the stepwise prediction function implemented by the regression tree.